So, now this should work. Yeah, sorry for that. I didn't plug in my headphones. I mean, the speaker's microphone. That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah, this is the World Cup match between Germany and India, and I'm playing against JSH, and we just started. I opened Forage a Spice Merchant, and then bought a silver on turn 3. Now it's my turn 4. And I think I get a Militia here. Militia seems like a nice terminal to play in this deck. There, I draw it right away. So now the question is, do you already start with the Groundskeepers? Or do you get like, I don't know what else to get. I think I get a Groundskeeper. And here it's just another Groundskeeper. My Spice Merchant misses the shuffle, unfortunately, but that's alright. Yeah, so the format is we play 6 games, and we have groups of 3 teams, and the top 2 teams advance, if I'm right on that, and they are going to play the quarterfinals then. Or is it already the semifinals? I'm not sure. I need to look that up. So here, do I want a gold at some point, or the maybe, but for the moment I just keep on hitting those Groundskeepers, I think. It's nice that I draw my Spice Merchant here. I'll hit 5 again, which is also pretty good. So I have all the Groundskeepers so far. Now his Militia should be coming in. Probably I'll discard Militia and Groundskeeper. Can also just discard 2 Groundskeepers. I want to attack him here. He's very thin, so the attack should hurt. And I also want to trash this copper. Yeah. So he gets a gold. I certainly also want a gold at some point. I don't get to 5. So what do I get? Then second silver? I can trash the silver too. I don't really want to trash the silver because then his 2 forages become stronger. Do I even want anything here? I mean, I could get... could get also a second forager, but I don't need it anymore. Do I even want anything? I could get a noble brigand, but... because he just shuffled. So his gold could be in those cards, but nah, seems a bit far-fetched. Not sure here. Yeah, so let's get a second silver, even though I'm not really happy about that, but I think I want to keep the silver to be able to hit 5 again. Hopefully. Yes. So he'll probably be able to play the militia every turn from now on. So maybe I should have gotten the goat earlier, because it might be hard to get it now as I'm attacked each turn. Let's discard like that. Yeah, I can't play the forager here. So what did he played a gold or a groundskeeper and then shuffled the deck. Yeah, that's a bit annoying now. I should have gotten this gold. Don't think I want anything here. Yeah. I think I discard like that and hope not to draw my forager. Maybe. Yeah, now he catches up on the groundskeepers. There's my forager. Yeah, I think I need to trash the silver, because I need forager to be worth 2 coins, I think. And then just buy another silver. Yeah. I mean, I think I was far ahead, but then I kind of lost track and let him catch up with the groundskeepers. So here, let's just start like this. So probably, yeah, so he got the Noble Brigand, which I talked about earlier, which means he didn't hit 5. And also don't hit 5 here. Man. Should I also get this Noble Brigand now? Try to hit his gold. What are the chances? He has 9 cards in his deck and I reveal... What does it reveal? 2 cards, so 2 and 9. Yeah, let's attack first. Discard a Spice Merchant. Yeah, whatever, I'm doing this as well. I'm gonna trash the Noble Brigand later. So he gained a copper, okay. Because he didn't reveal any treasures. Now I could afford the gold, but now I rather get the last groundskeeper. So should I attack him with the Noble Brigand or with the militia? I wonder. Hitting his gold would be really cool. Attacking him by giving him a copper doesn't really matter, because yeah, maybe he even profits from that because it's new fuel for his foragers. But hitting the gold would be so cool. The question is which attack hurts more. I mean, I could also trash the Noble Brigand and play the militia. What would that give me? 8 coins. Okay. Could buy Groundskeeper Estate. Yeah, let's do that. And just not get the gold ever, probably, and rather just buy estates and trash them again with the forager. Groundskeeper, yeah, Spine State. Yeah, no. Yeah, maybe I should have kept the forager around. Okay. I'll buy another estate here. Yeah, so maybe having this gold isn't all that important as I first thought it would be. I mean, it was nice for him to get the groundskeepers more easily when being attacked with militia, but other than that, okay, of course it's still nice to have it, but I think I can do without. So he treasures his militia, gets an apprentice. State. Okay. So he won't attack me anymore, which is good. So I think I also get an apprentice here because I'll be adding estates into my deck. I already have two and only one forager. Plus the apprentice is the obelisk pile, so could also get the gold here. Don't have a gold. Yeah, but what does that bring me? I probably won't be buying provinces anyway, so let's just get an apprentice. Yeah, he trashed his spice merchant. I can also do that rather soon. I'm still thinking about what to discard, but he doesn't have a militia anymore, so don't have to worry about that. Yeah, replace is nice, you can do that, exactly. Give me a curse. I would like to get the last, the remaining estates here if possible. And I will. So I rather trash an estate because, yeah, spice merchant might be handy. And I can treasure with apprentice, which gives more cards. So I got all five groundskeepers out. It's pretty good. Alright, so two piles are empty, but the third one is probably not inside yet. Okay, forages are a bit low, but nice, here I can trash the estate. Do I trash a silver? Yeah, probably I do. I only have one. Ah, I have two groundskeepers in play, but yeah. Getting rid of a silver is okay, yeah, I think. Turn continues like that. Alright, so crush the curse and play the militia. Just buy that she. Don't need to buy copper, do I? Nah. Of course not, if you look at that hand. So he trashes another forager. He resigned. Okay. I was a starting player. So he's a starting player now. Okay. What's under the druid? Flames gift? River's gift? What does that do? One card at the end of the turn, and Forest's gift. Coin and a buy. Okay. So the Flames gift should be pretty helpful to trash coppers. You can trash your shelters with a hermit. The question is, do you want to trash the coppers or do you want to play with the miser? Miser is always a bit slow, of course. But this game should take some time, so I think. I think that the miser is worth it. He has a 5-2, which is pretty okay. I think Margrave Druid looks decent. Yeah, with the shelters, I don't like the Swindler as much. I rather open. Yeah, like Hermit Miser, maybe. Hermit is also nice with Pilgrimage. If you have 4 and a Hermit, which is, to be fair, at the start not all that likely, but then you can Pilgrimage and get a Madman. So do I do the Miser thing or not? I think I do it. Yeah, and is it worth to get a Druid? So, one card at the end of this turn and trashing. Not sure. I mean, I need to watch my terminate space, right? So I have the necro. Yeah, let's get one druid. My hermit misses the shuffle. It's a bit unfortunate. I think I'll just buy a silver here. I have enough terminals already. But his Margrave also misses the shuffle. Or it didn't, and he decided to not play it. So do I put a copper on the mat here, or do I trash this overgrown estate? I think I trash the overgrown estate and get another hermit, because I don't have anything good to buy anyway. It's a bit unfortunate that I draw my druid, but oh well. So I could get a second silver here, or I could pilgrimage. Pilgrimage will be nice later with city quarters. Not sure if I want it already, but yeah. Let's just do it. So here I can play my Madman. Miser misses, but okay. One card at the end of this turn. Yeah, I think Pilgrimage maybe was a bit premature, because now it doesn't make any sense to do the thing I mentioned before, play the Hermit and do Pilgrimage, because I don't have anything good to gain yet. But okay, let's play the Hermit. I rather would have liked to do it here, but now that my journey token is already flipped, I can't do it. So what do I get here? Just another silver. I think I get a second silver, and I just get a coin here and buy a Margrave, maybe. Yeah. Okay, so I should be getting a city quarter soon. So he doesn't play with the miser. So my goal should be to prolong this game so the miser effect will be worth it. Do I buy a city quarter for 2 here? I mean, you have to start at some point, right? Yeah, let's just do it. Yeah, and also when you're in debt, I forgot that. It's also nice to play the Hermit and get a free madman, basically. So I think I just get another Hermit with the Hermit. The question is, do I trash my Necro? I think I keep it around for the moment. Gain another Hermit. Gain a madman. Yeah, he attacks me here. Let's look at that beautiful hand. What do I do? So maybe... I want to play the City Quarter and the Margrave. So I keep those and I think I save the... save the Madman for later, so discard like that. I will draw a copper most likely. Yeah, put that on the mat. Should be okay. And he trashes a copper, it's just annoying, but that's what happens. So he gets a miser now, okay. So I think... I can't afford it, right? That's too bad. It would have been a nice spot to pilgrimage, but if I put copper on the mat, I'm missing one coin because I'm still in debt. I could profit. Could profit here. It's just a perfect timing, more or less, to get the pilgrimage. It's before the shuffle, and I have three nice cards in play. But I don't get a copper down. But I think I still do it. Because that will also accelerate the frequency of which I'll be putting down coppers on the mat. So, do I get anything else with the pilgrimage? Like another druid, but that doesn't seem necessary. Okay, let's pilgrimage for Miser, Margrave, City Quarter. Could get another City Quarter. Or a druid. Yeah, let's just get another City Quarter. It's maybe a bit of an overkill, but yeah, and that draw kind of sucks. Yeah, okay. He also had a bad draw. Alright, so can I maybe still save the madman and just play Necro Margrave? Hoping to draw, I mean, I will most likely draw City Quarters. I think I will draw my deck either way, so I'll try to do it like that. Save the madman for bad times. Alright, so... can I gain anything? He trashed my Hermit, which is a bit annoying because I also have that curse here. Now yeah, let's just draw it all. Not even all. Okay, I still have the Margrave. So the question is, the first question is, what is my last card? It's another City Quarter, right? So it would be nice to have that on top. So I think I don't play the Margrave, I play two Misers and a Druid. What do I do with the Druid? Trash the Curse, probably? Yeah. copper to matte, copper to matte, and crash the curse. So I can buy something for 6 here. Could be just another miser. How many coppers do I have down? 4. Could also be just another pilgrimage. Yeah, let's do pilgrimage. Two buys. Think about copper and city quarter. Yeah. Whoa. I mean, what kind of draw is that? Should have skipped the copper. But those are my coppers, right? So it's pretty unfortunate. I wanted to do another pilgrimage for the last city quarter, but it's not going to happen. Ah, okay, I get it like that. So, how do we continue from here? Probably get a third miser. But first let's plan the city quarter. Play a Margrave. Play a city quarter. So I have 4 city quarters, right? Which would mean the last card is again a city quarter. Okay. Yeah, I think this time I was far ahead. So and I also didn't change the score here. It's 2-0. Alright, what's going on here? I have the chapel and the scrying pool. Should be pretty powerful. We have scrying pool and artificer, which is a pretty big combo here. I think I just open potion. Potion chapel. I mean, there are no buys, but the artificer. Ah, no, Kochi is a buy. I wanted to say there are no buys, but artificer is also some sort of close to a buy. I think you want as many scrying pools and artificer as possible. So I think I just open potion chapel. Could also be gear chapel, but I want to get the scrying pools as soon as I can. Okay, that's nice. I don't draw the chapel with my potion. Otherwise I wouldn't have known what to do. Oh, that's a perfect draw. Okay, the potion. What do I do with the potion? I think I just... You don't need to trash all your coppers here. So I think I just top deck the potion and discard his potion. And just trash one estate and buy another scrying pool. Another way you can make use of the overdraw is with plazas, but then the coppers are in the discard and you don't draw them up again with scrying pool. So artificer is the way to go. Can also activate some diplomats if you would like to do that, but it's not even needed. Yeah, you need some economy at some point. So like here, do I even trash? Do I even trash this copper? I think I have 4 coppers left, right? Yeah, I'm not sure if I even want to get another scrying pool here. I need to get to 5. How did the trashing go? So I trashed 3 coppers and then nothing else. So I have 4 coppers remaining. So I could trash. I think I just trash the estate and buy a silver here. So my payload in this deck should be at 6 at the moment. So I think I trash one more copper and buy a scrying pool. So I should be able to afford an artificer this turn. Or do I want a courtier first? I don't think so. So doesn't really matter, I think. I could have top decked this, but anyway. So artificer is, that is what I want, right? Yeah. And then you can start to trash down more. Discard, discard, top deck, discard. That was a nice attack for me. Alright, so can I already gain something useful here? What would that be? I could get second artificer by discarding 3 copper, silver, and chapel. Yeah, but then I trigger the shuffle and I'm only left with treasures in my deck. That sucks. I mean, I can also just buy another artificer. Yeah, not so clear to me. I mean, I could also discard 5 cards and get the artificer and just buy another scrying pool. That seems like the best thing to do. So like that. Can't trash them, but it's okay for the moment. So our decks are pretty similar right now. I have 2 artificers. The scrying pools are split. He has 2 silvers. And the coppers. I have 1 more copper, something like that. Let's discard. No, let's top deck the silver. Yeah, that was probably not ideal, but should have maybe played the artificer first. Anyway, how to do this now? Should I just load my deck with actions, even if I don't play them? Just to have more draw for the scrying pool artificer thing? Like, for example, I could get a gear here. What else could I do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Could get another artificer. Yeah, I think I can afford that. Now the draw will stop at some point, but I think that's okay. Now I could get a gear. I mean, the gear is only... okay. No need to bother. So it looks like he has more time, so I'm the starting player again. Is that right? No, he's the starting player, right? So, those are some quick games. It's 3-0. Okay. So what's going on here? We have a lucky coin and a masterpiece. So you can go and gain lots of silvers here. Only thing missing is Theodom for that to be good. So Triumphal Arch. You have the second most common action card, okay. So I think you want to get a black market and a red catcher for the opening, maybe. And then maybe there's something useful in the black market, because on the board there is not all that much going on, to be honest. You can play Embassy Big Money. You can put Lost Arts on Embassy. Maybe that's a thing. Yeah, you might want to do that, because there's also Lucky Coin, which helps a lot for some big money thing. Then you're not getting any Triumphal Arch points, or at least not all that many. How would you do that to maximize those? I mean, you don't want to get reds. I mean, you can get some, because you get some silvers, but you can trash, you can even buy a big masterpiece, but that's all not all that great. So, yeah, I think I want a black market anyway. But the real question is, do I maybe just play Lost Arts on Embassy Big Money here? That would probably mean not even trashing with Ratcatcher, but rather getting a Skulk here. Yeah, usually that I wouldn't do that, but it looks interesting here, so let's try it. So that's a nice draw, maybe find something useful in the black market. He also gets a Skulk. Okay, that's interesting. That is indeed interesting. Because of the Doctor. I mean, if I want to play this Embassy Big Money thing, I don't need to trash all that much. But here it's really tempting. I could overpay by 4. There's the Skulk in the deck, but even that I could trash, so I could basically trash. Yeah, okay, there's also silver and the lucky coin in there. I mean, if I get the Doctor here, then I won't be playing Embassy Big Money, I think, because then I want to try to get thin. Not sure here. Man, this embassy big money thing looks kind of attractive to me. Doctor overpay by 4, trash like 3 cards or something. It's a bit against my usual thing, because I would like to build an engine, but Lost Arts is so attractive here. I just don't buy it. I even start with the Lost Arts. Cool, I get to 5 here, so that was worth it. So I think I made my intentions clear to him. Question is, how does he react? Yeah, just buy an embassy here, and then I basically start greening. And with 5, I just buy more embassies. So here, could get a fool, but that's probably foolish. Okay. I would like to have a buy at some point. I mean, I have the skulk, okay. Let's just get a silver. You know, those are some nice cards for him. Like the upgrade or the highway, probably. Okay, it's an upgrade, yes. So let's see. The play market has to offer. Just play all the cards. Yeah, Spice Merchant seems kind of useful here for the buy, maybe even. I mean, I said I want to green, but I think I get Spice Merchant and Embassy here. And probably another embassy here. Could get a crown, but it's kind of similar to an embassy, because I would like to crown embassies. I mean, I can crown silvers, but then it's not all that good, so let's just get another embassy. Okay. I hope to draw one embassy from the spice merchant here. Okay. Don't. Envious. Okay, silvers and golds. Ah, coppers. Do I get a courtier? I mean, I have now the skulk and the spice merchant for buy. I think I just get another embassy. And I should be. Ah, I could have gotten an inn here, but it's okay. Do I get a rat catcher? I think it doesn't hurt because I have the actions on embassy, so let's do that. Yeah, it's a bit unfortunate that all my embassies are clocked up at the bottom here, but what can you do? How many embassies do I have? Like 4? It's a guardian, okay. Discard those. So I probably will be using the spice merchant for buy, unless I find the the Skulk here. Do I really have four embassies? So even if I have, I don't want to play one if I draw it here, so let's just play it. And just if I discard, Black Market Embassy Copper, then play the Spice Merchant for coins and buy, then I have 2, 3, 11, 14, I think. Yeah, I think I'm doing that. I discarded an embassy here, so I could get province in if I want to make sure to have an embassy in the starting hand. I mean, in also reduces your hand size by one, so you also discard a lot of cards with embassy already, but I'm able to play maybe Skulk and Spice Merchant or something at some point, so I think I'll do that. And put the embassy and in back. Do I put a Black Market back? Yeah, I think it can't. Can it hurt? Theoretically it can, but let's just put it. Nah, let's not put it back. There was tiny risk of embassy and in being bottom decked, so that my turn would stop right away, so I don't want to risk that. Like that, I was guaranteed to start the turn by drawing. So do I trash an estate? Probably not, right? I want to discard. Okay. Looks like he still has time. And that was the 4-0 in my favor. Alright, what's going on here? Ambassador, first and foremost. Question is, do you open double ambassador or Caravan Ambassador, or maybe Shepherd Ambassador, but not sure about the Shepherd. Yeah, not sure. I think I open Caravan Ambassador. You can also try to get like two lighthouses and play them in alternating turns to be protected from ambassador, but in order to do that you have to get thin first. Yeah, maybe double ambassador is just better here, but I never like it when they collide. Let's see what he does. And now I'm also guaranteed to play the ambassador. This turn even? Okay, which doesn't matter. I would have liked to... Ah, it doesn't matter. Return the coppers. So here I could get like a second ambassador. I have four, okay, so I probably rather get a caravan. Yes. Yeah, so he gets a lighthouse, which is sensible. Probably should also get a lighthouse here. So next turn I will be faced with the decision if I want to play the caravan and trigger a shuffle. If I want to do that, I probably should add a second ambassador here to have one in the deck, or I just not I just don't play the caravan, but that's also a bit strange. Not sure if you can follow me, but anyway. Not playing the caravan feels a bit strange. Feels a bit strange, so let's play it. It's nice that I draw an estate. Do I get a second lighthouse? I think I do. So here I can get a second caravan, third caravan. Or I can buy a butcher or a city. Don't like the soothsayer yet. Yeah, city or butcher. Yeah, let's get a butcher as well. So now I'm protected, which is pretty cool. Because I need to watch out, I think he's a bit ahead on the ambassador front, so... So he's also protected. I think I still want to return two coppers here. Do I want a third? A lighthouse. I am not sure about that. I mean, it's money-wise, if you don't draw your deck, it's like a silver, but... Yeah, I think I get one. Not sure that's right, but yeah, it increases the chances of being protected every single turn, so it's okay. And now I want a city next, I think. So he gains a shepherd. And also his third lighthouse. So do I play... Do you play this lighthouse? If I play it, I can trash state into another lighthouse. That seems a bit much. I mean, I can do that anyway, but then I would hit 5 and be able to buy a city. I mean, the reason for not playing it is that I have it, can play it next turn, but I think I play it, and then I butcher the estate into another lighthouse, or also into a shepherd. I'm not sure about the shepherd. Maybe. I mean, so many lighthouses, they don't really help. Yeah, I think, of course, I get a caravan. What am I talking about? What am I talking about? So I think I get a city here. So he gets shepherds. Is he protected? Yes, he is protected. So I think... I just return one copper. No, I can return two. I still have 5. So do I want to get a soothsayer? I think I want to get a soothsayer, even though it's probably only gives you goals because he will be protected most of the time, but I think it's still okay because you can trash golds into provinces later. So he trashes ambassador, which is pretty sensible, I think. So he's protected. I can't return the pasture or anything. So I wonder if I should trash also my ambassador into something more useful, like another city. Or another caravan for that matter. Yeah, I think I'll do that. Butcher my ambassador. So the ambassador was officially over, and we both have 3 lighthouses, which aren't the greatest, but it's okay. Trash is an ambassador, so if I get a caravan here, I'm using 1 coin, and then I only have 3. Could get a... It's a bit annoying, I only have 7 total, basically. Let's get a caravan. And just buy nothing here. So how many states does he have? Okay, so he transitions into like an estate shepherd kind of deck, which is interesting. Do I trash the lighthouse? I think I do, for another caravan probably. So will the cities be activated ever? I mean, not very likely for the buy, so I mean I could just province here. And then I'll be also able to add shepherds into the deck, which would do something for me. Yeah, let's just screen. I mean the city level 2 will certainly not be activated, but maybe the draw. First one, I mean. Yeah, the estates are also worth 2 points because of pasture, which is something to always keep in mind. So wait, is it 4-0 or 5-0? Getting confused here. Okay, so I don't find my city, so I have to decide if I want to play the butcher or the soothsayer, and I think I play the soothsayer. Buy another city here. Could also buy a shepherd. But yeah, I think the city is fine. So he has 12 points. What is the province? And 3 estates, probably. Yeah, this one looks good for him. Because of those shepherds. I mean, not sure if you need 4, but I think he had a good idea here with transitioning into shepherds. So I can get double province here, and I probably should. I don't find my soothsayer though, but can't have everything here. Yeah, maybe I need a shepherd now, but I can't get it here. Yeah, if you can double province again, then I'm kind of lost. I think he probably is able to do, but I needed to play it like that anyway, I think. Yeah. So he can trash a gold into a province, buy a province, most likely. Then I am I won't be able to catch up. Okay. Okay, he can do some gain and play tricks. Can he even win here now? No. Doesn't have the actions. Also, that doesn't make sense what I'm saying. So he can't double province. Oh, he could have. I don't know why he didn't then. Oh no, he couldn't, right? He has 5 coins and then he would have missed 1 coin. Okay, but he probably will be able to do so next turn. Question is, okay, let's play this first. So it would have been cool if I would have been able to double province, but can't. So how to do this? So he's protected. Yeah, it's too bad I didn't get any shepherds and now it's probably too late. I can double duchy here. I mean, if he can double province, he's winning anyway, so I think I should get 1 province. So I think I trash the gold into province by a shepherd, maybe. Trash the gold into province, play the soothsayer by a shepherd. Yeah, so he will be winning this one, as it seems. Yeah, I'm pretty happy that those games are rather quick, because I'll be playing another match right after that one. I have to play my last match in the league against Kois, which will be pretty interesting because we are very close to each other. He's leading by 1 point and this is the last match of the season, so whoever wins, I mean, it's enough for him to play to tie 3-3, then he'd win. If I win 4-2, then I would win. So what happened here? He trashed the lighthouse for an estate, so he didn't want to touch a province, so he wasn't able to double province, as it seems. Okay. Now it would be a good time to draw a shepherd. Nope. I mean, next turn will be good, but now he must be able to get double province, right? So I just buy a duchy here. I just realized the flag looks a bit strange because of the black background. Okay. So maybe we'll get the whole match done, which wasn't to be expected beforehand. Okay, what's going on here? Sauna silver for trashing and forge for trashing. Yeah, but most important thing here is governor, of course. I have the 5-2. It would be nice to get some trashing in with sauna silver, but with the 5-2, I think it's just open governor. You can also do like a big forge trash, drawing up with governors. Ah, that's a bit of a bad draw here. I usually don't want to draw with governor that early, I'd rather get a gold. But in this case I think I draw because I can't buy anything for 2, and I get a sauna here as well. He gets his first trashing in, which is good for him. And he gets a bridge troll over governor. Okay. So let's get a second sauna. And here I just gain a gold, I think. Then I need a silver. But I don't want a silver here. Let's get a gold and an Avanto. Probably will be buying my silver here. Even though I'm not even sure I should have gone for the saunas. I mean, I said that you can trash with forge, so. Now I maybe kind of helped him a bit with uncovering the Avantos, because now he has some nice sauna Avanto thing going on. He gets a leprechaun, that's interesting. Let's draw here. And just buy another Avanto. Now I should get a bridge troll. So, trash an estate. What can I do here? Can also get a forge. Totally not sure I'm playing this right. Yeah, let's get the forge. Only one governor board so far at turn 9 just seems wrong, to be honest. Governor turns, like, they tend to end turn 13, 14 or something, and yeah, I think I just should have gone heavy governor, probably. Alright, so here, let's play Son Avanto, and just get another gold, I guess. And another governor. Yeah, I want to get a useful forge trashing, and that's why I got another governor over bridge troll or something. But here I think I get a bridge troll. So let's hope I draw a sauna here and then continue drawing. Yeah, I have two saunas, right? So the chances are not that high, but yeah, he makes this leprechaun work kind of nicely. Doesn't look good for me, this game. So I can trash an estate into a leprechaun. Probably that's too late for that. Still going to do it, but yeah. I mean, all this forge thing and saunas and silvers, it's just pretty much useless, I think. Yeah, okay, I draw the sauna at least, which is pretty good. So now let's just draw and trash some stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sauna Avanto. The leprechaun would give me a wish here, but of course I'm going to play the forge. And so how do I trash here? I have the minus coin token, which is important because otherwise I could trash a gold into a grand market and buy a province. But here I can trash all the coppers, a leprechaun and a silver into a grand market and buy a province. That seems okay. I think I have like plenty of overdraw now, which is not all that great, or rather like unnecessary, but yeah, I think I trash the leprechaun, the silver, in the grand market, buy a province. Okay, it's nice that I draw my Avanto here, so I can start with Sauna Avanto. Can trash a copper into an estate, but that's a bit ridiculous. Could get the leprechaun back, but this game is about to end. So I just don't do anything. Yeah, he gains those wishes. It's pretty nice. Maybe I should get this leprechaun back actually. Let's just do it. Could trash a sauna into a governor, but I need to play the thorn on this turn, so it's not happening. Sorry, I think I start with thorn Avanto, or do I draw with the governor first once? Yeah, I think I do that. It's safer. Thorn Avanto. No sauna, okay. But there's a sauna left, so I can think about in which order I want to play those cards. I think I play Avanto, sauna. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I do. Yeah, I'm missing the actions here to do useful things. Like gain the bridge troll in play and play the leprechaun. I have to decide between those two things. First I think I play the governor for gold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Gain gold. And then the question is leprechaun or oh okay, I think I just made this decision because I already have 7 cards in play, so let's play the bridge troll. Okay, should I just play all the treasures or somehow try to hide what I have? Question is, what do I want to buy? I have 14. three buys. I only have two governors. That's just not enough. So I can play this copper by province double governor. Or should I rather buy double province? Triple should be kind of easy for him. Yeah, I think I bet province double governor. Yeah, whatever. Province. Piles are not in danger, right? He can't pile estates or something. So, good thing is that I have a bridge troll in play, but yeah, let's see how he draws here. Looks like, yeah, he can probably quadruple. With the wishes, that's pretty cool. Yeah, I think I kind of have to get a province there, right? No province left for me. Alright, so the match ends 4-2 in my favor. He comes back by winning the last two games. Yeah, we looks like we just made it in time. Okay, so I hope, let's pull the, I wanted to have a look at the groups and stuff. Where is it? Yeah, alright, so here is the World Cup thingy. We are in group A with RTT, myself, Marcus and E-Honda, and with us in the group is Finland and India, and we are playing against India in the first match, and I think I played the first match. So I'm playing against Chase H, and I think tomorrow RTT will be playing against Sackett, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not sure about the other two games, but good thing is that we are kind of evenly strong along four tables, and we should be favorites on table 3 or 4. And then I think the top two teams go to the... So how many teams do we have then? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 8 teams. So that's the quarterfinal, right? Yeah. Okay. Anyway, just wanted to have a look at that for myself because I didn't really check it all that much. Here you can see the matchups. Alright, anyway. Thanks for watching. I hope those were kind of interesting games, and for my usual speed of play, I think they were pretty quick. Alright, see you guys.